Thanks, Gia. In vino veritas. In other words, in wine, there's truth. Our wine guy, Gary Vaynerchuk, believes the wine industry is one big misconception. And he's on a mission to encourage people to trust their own tastes. Gary is here to debunk common myths about the wine industry. Good morning, Gary. How you doing?
Morning, man. How are you?
Good to see you. All right, well, let's start with the most common myth of all, which is, of course, that the more expensive the wine, the better it is.
Bull. Completely.
You would have completed that, but we're on morning television.
Absolutely.
I understand.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So, you know, the fact of the matter is we're in America, mm-hmm. and marketing is king.
Right.
You're a brand, you charge more.
Right.
If not, you can't. And so there's so much quality coming from so many places in the world, and you know, if it has a Napa or Bordeaux price tag on it, you're gonna pay more. But there's so many little spots like Portugal and South Africa where you can get great value.
And there's so many products that we all know, besides wine, of course, where you're paying for the marketing. It's like paying for the packaging on something.
I'd love to see how much a Mercedes would cost if you took that hood on or mitt off.
Exactly.
You know,
you
same
go.
Thing.
Okay, so what's our second myth here? We're talking about well-known vineyards. You know, when you think about the well-known vineyards, you say, well, they've got to have the best wines. Also, maybe not true.
Also, once again, not true. I think people have to start realizing that wine is much more like food. You have to trust your own taste.
Right.
And
well,
so
I think a lot of us, we see that we think of wine and we think of people with holding the stem.
Absolutely.
Think you have to be sophisticated in order to enjoy it, but that's not true, right?
I really don't think so. I think I started really seeing the change about 3 or 4 years ago when I started seeing wine at NASCAR events. I was like, okay, wine is clearly making
wine
the change over. Yeah,
right.
Absolutely. I think there's just so many bad myths, people, you know, so many stuffed up people, and that's why I started Wine Library TV. Because, you know, I'm a New York Jets fan that goes out and screams at people to try different things and try, you know, to find wines that they like, not because the Wine Spectator, Robert Parker, or even myself is telling them to drink it.
Now, I like this next one because I'm a white wine fan, but I have some of these red wine snobs that look at me and say, well, you're a girly guy,
right?
Yeah, you don't know sophisticated wines, you know, but that's not true, is it?
Absolutely not. As a matter of fact, most of the master sommeliers and the real serious wine aficionados that I know, when we get into our cave of wine nerddom and talk about wine, Riesling, which is a grape a lot of people think is for girls and sweet, is probably the most respected grape in the world. So that's a white grape. It's just another classic example of the wine snob world trying to, you know, come down on people.
And another way they do that is they say, if there's one vineyard that you like, you should stick with that. But that's not true because why?
Because I'm sick and tired of everybody drinking Yellowtail and Kendall Jackson and Santa Margarita. It's like people find that one wine that they love,
right,
and they drink it like it's got the cure inside.
Right.
Over and over. A complete disaster. Listen, I love White Castle sliders, but I don't want to eat them every single meal of my life. And that's what people are doing with wine.
How about this last myth?
Yep.
It's easier to chug wine from a box. Is that true?
That is absolutely true.
Okay.
Bring a funnel.
I thought it was. All right. Thanks, buddy. For more information, of course, you can check out our website at dailybuzz.tv. Hey, still more to come here on the Daily Buzz. We're giving away $100 in our Daily Buzz Cash Cow giveaway. Find out if you're the winner. The Daily Buzz returns in just a moment.